Hey everybody, we're back with another IMP slash MRE meal review. This is the Canadian IMP, expires 2013, menu number 8, sweet and sour pork. And this is undamaged as best as I can tell. The second to last video I did, we had some problems with the sugar packets being exploded. So I'm going to take this apart, open this up, break it down with you. Stay with me. Alright, here we go, we'll open this up. Now, for those of you who don't know, these are packaged in the brown paper bag, but the inside of it has a metallic lining. So it's, as far as I know, very weather resistant. I'm not sure if it's waterproof. Now, this one looks to be pretty intact, so we'll start taking stuff out of here. Give me just a moment. All right, so here we go. Open the bag up all the way. Keep our recycling over there in a handy spot. And we'll start. Well, from dead center, we have the pop peanut butter. We have strawberry jam. We have matches. We have a Werther's Original. A little one. A tiny one, even. We have jammed here hot chocolate. Excellent. We have, wow, Nescafe 3-in-1 instant coffee mix. Tear here, it says on the top. I just want to see where this is made. Oh, I can't quite read what it says. And it says the date of 2014 March, which is the expiry of this guy, so it's a little more than that today. We have a commercial package of mini Oreos. And those, do they have a stale date on them? No. Yes, it says they do over here. Well, the stale date on this is August 2013. Alright, well, again, it's later than that. Put it on the dessert corner. We have buttered rice. This is one of those items that brings us into the realm of MRE or not MRE. Because this is not ready to eat unless you want to crunch on some dry rice. You need approximately, I think it's 200 and some mils of water. It doesn't really tell you, it just says fill to the dotted line, which is here. So that's probably going to be at least 100 mils or about 4 or 5 ounces of boiling water. You could do it with cold water. I think it'll still work, but I'm not sure how appetizing that's going to be. Back into the package, we have tortillas. Excellent. Put that there. We have two packages of sports drink, both grape flavored. Or raisin, if you're a Frenchie. We have the sports drink or beverage container. I'm still going here, folks. We have a hot sauce, which is a chili sauce, very similar to what you get at Wendy's. So if you want to compare that, that's the best thing I can think of after my few videos here for a comparison. We have the nicely long-handled spoon, which you can get down deep into these packages if you open from the top to bottom versus side to side. We have the towels, which are pretty sturdy. You can wipe your face with them, or you can conserve those and maybe use them as TP in the field if you needed to. We have your dental gum. And we have last, not the last. Hang on, don't get excited yet. We have a wet wipe. And we have a wooden toothpick. That's the entrance of this package. But now we have the main packages. We have, as a dessert, sliced pears. I've had those before. You might see them on some of my other videos. And we have sweet and sour pork. I'm going to get those in the hot water and heat them up, and then I'll come back with you. All right, while I've got those two mains in the hot water, I'm going to go through their dates here. The sweet and sour pork is from the year 2012, the 187th day. The sliced pears are from 2012 and the 268th day. And how you tell is you read these numbers here. The first two is the year, and the last three are the day of the year. So there's that one. There's that one. I'm going to look and see if the tortillas here, have a date on them, and they do. 2012, 229th day. Rice may or may not. And they've actually got an imprint on the side here. 12244. I'll bring that up close, but I know my camera doesn't macro real easy, so there you go. The peanut butter, this one's, pardon me, this is the strawberry jam. That's from the 237th day of 2012. Peanut butter, which is feeling like it's getting a little thick. I might put that in the hot water too. That's from 2012, the 262nd day. The hot sauce, yep. 2012, 289th day. There you go. So a lot of this stuff is made in the fall of 2012. So it is now currently today, May 16th, 2015. So this stuff is all pretty well expired by their measurements, but I'm going to delve in there anyways. So humor me a little bit and we'll be back with some warmed up mains. Okay, well, I fibbed a little bit. I'm going to come back with this 3-in-1 coffee, instant coffee mix deal here. I'm not sure what the 3-in-1 exactly refers to, but if I look at the ingredients, I don't usually drink the coffees and the teas and stuff in these packs, and I'll be doing a series of taste testing probably in a few months just solely on the beverages. But I look at the ingredients, it says the first ingredient is sugar, and we all know that in Canada the first ingredient is whatever there's the most of in the product. So sugar, the next is glucose syrup solids, and they define that from tapioca and wheat, so it's not from corn. Next ingredient is hydrogenated vegetable oil, palm kernel oil, coconut oil, instant coffee, skim milk powder, sodium caseinate, dipotassium phosphate, sodium citrate, acetylated syrup, no, tartaric acid, pardon me, esters of monoglycerides, flavor and artificial colors, silicon dioxide, and salt. This doesn't really sound like something I want to put in my body unless I have to. So at this point, I don't have to. I'm just doing a fun review. So I'm going to keep this and save this for another day. The other beverage we have here for a hot beverage is hot chocolate. This takes 170 mils of water, and mixed with that, you're looking at 110 calories, little tiny bit of fat, tiny bit of cholesterol, 180 mg of sodium, 22 grams of carbs, 1 gram of fiber, and 21 grams of sugar. So this again is, it's energy, but it's not vitamins, it's calories. It's what my mom would call empty calories. There's no vitamin content really here at all. There's 6% of your daily iron and 15% of your calcium, which is pretty minimal. I would consider that basically almost useless. So that's what I'm coming back with. Next, I'm going to come back with the mains. So hang tight. Give me 2 more minutes. All right, so we are back with our heated up mains. These are from the Baxter's company. And I'll open up the sliced apples. The sliced apples or pears? Sliced pears, pardon me. Sliced pears first. Now it shows a pair of scissors here. Now I'm trying to tear this without, and I don't have any fingernails. There we go. And that was a little bit. Oh, that's fine. It happened. Okay, there's some juice. That's really hot. I left it in a pot of water that I had boiled and then took off the boil and let them sit in there for about 6 or 7 minutes. The same with my sweet and sour pork, which also has the same little scissors picture. But I'm just going to go ahead and try and rip that by hand. There you go. I've not really encountered a lot of military personnel that pack scissors around in their EDC, nor do I. Actually, that's not true. I think I might have a pair of scissors on my one of my multi-tools, or a Swiss Army knife or something. Oh, that smells really good. All right, so that is sweet and sour pork and sliced pears, and I'm gonna smell that. And that does smell tasty. You can see there's some really good chunks in here, actual pieces of meat. It's 2 to 3 year old meat, but still, it's meat. And there's a generous sauce in here. You can see my tray is well filled, but not overpowered. Now, I've got the rice going over here. I added the water, and then it said wait 8 minutes. It's been 5 minutes since, so I'm still waiting a little bit on that. But it is soaking up the water. It's sort of like a minute rice, just fluffy, kind of pre-cooked. Just needs to rehydrate rice. So there you have it. That's my plating. Give me a couple minutes to let that rice finish up, and then we'll get into the tasting. All right, so I've made up my grape drink, mixed it up, and it mixed pretty well. There's a little bit of undissolved stuff in there, but for the most part, it came out clean. Give that a quick taste. Yeah, good flavor. Very strong grape flavor. I would liken that to a Kool-Aid type product versus a Gatorade type product. So there you go. All right, so I'm coming back now. I'm going to go after my mains, but I'm going to leave the hot sauce out. I know what it tastes like. I don't need it right now. Strawberry jam is strawberry jam. If you look at any of my other videos, I don't usually bother tasting it. Peanut butter is peanut butter. The consistency of this is a little tough, but I think that's because of the age. It just feels a little thick. So if I was going to eat this, I would put that in, if I could, a little bit of hot water, or stick it in a pocket that's close to my body for a little while, get it warm up, thin out a bit. But I'm going to go after the mains here now. First, we'll start with the dessert. The little Oreos, they're all intact. A little bit of wear and tear on them, but overall, they're not smashed into oblivion. It's protected well between those two packages the way they are inside the IMP. So that's a no-brainer that they're okay. My rice is still absorbing water, but very close to having absorbed most of it. I'll get you a close-up here. Hopefully the lighting's okay for that. So there it is, still steaming. But I'm going to try this sweet and sour pork. So a bit of sauce, looks like peppers, and a bit of meat. Tastes just fine. Good mouthfeel. The pork has still got a very good meat consistency, like a pork chop that's cooked thoroughly but not overcooked. The sauce is not overly spicy. A little bit sweet, a little bit sour, but this is not that different than anything you get from the Chinese place down the road. Yeah, it's all right. Get a bite of the rice here. It's gonna be hot, careful. Mm-hmm. Just like I thought, that's gonna be just like any minute rice that you're gonna make. So, not gluey, not sticky at all, just a nice consistency. You can see that there. Mm-hmm. Very acceptable. I'm gonna try a pear slices. This one I've had in another video, but I'll try it again now. Perfect. I mean, that's the same consistency of anything anything out of a can that I've had for sliced fruit. It's sweet as heck because of all this juice and the fruit itself. So this is going to be a high-calorie item, but I'm assuming there's still some vitamin value to the pears, just as it would be if they were canned. I really like the sweet and sour pork. Give me 1 minute. I'll go grab those tortillas. I'll be back with you. All right, so we have the tortillas. These ones are not from the Baxter. This is from the Warnick Company, which I know when I watch Gundog and Kiwi Dude and the other couple of fellows that have the huge followings and do the MRE reviews, that's one of the companies that's come up a few times. So it's interesting, though, that one military would rely on another country's supplier of foods. If one came to head with one another, there would definitely be somebody that would be in ahead of that battle, just removing the supply. So here we go, tortillas. Again, these are from 2012, they're 229th day, so we're probably talking maybe August-ish. They're well heated in the hot water. Let's see if I can get them apart without breaking them. Yep, no problem here. We'll do the flap test. This might be something new that I do. There you go. We'll fold it. Still intact. So that's a tortilla. It smells just as good as any tortilla you've had in the grocery store. Take a bit of rice in there. Take a bit of sweet and sour pork. Come on. Some Mexican Asian fusion cooking now here. Got sweet and sour pork out of Asia. And we've got tortillas out of Mexico. Wrap that up. Take a bite. Nothing wrong with that. I'm going to put that aside. Use the towel. So I am going to go ahead and finish this, but I want you all to know that the sweet and sour pork, it's a great dish. It's a nice variance from other things that you get in these meals. And if you have your chance to get your hands on any of these, if you're prepping or camping or hiking or just want to try something new and have something fun, definitely two thumbs up. I thank you for watching, and we'll see you on the next one.